Nelson Kodak Company is happy to bring you America's favorite family, the Nelsons. Ozzie, Harriet, David, and Ricky. And now for Eastman Chrome Spun, made by Eastman Chemical Products, a member of the Eastman Kodak family. Here's Harriet Nelson.
You know, for most people, the hardest part of furnishing a house is finding fabrics and colors that go together. Well, now you can take the guesswork out of decorating. And here's how Eastman Chrome Spun makes it possible.
Eastman Chrome Spun acetate fiber comes in colors that always match. When you choose fabrics that have this Eastman Chrome Spun House of Color tag, you can't make a mistake. You can color coordinate your entire house. Take your draperies and couch. No matter what fabric you choose, you can find a match with Chrome Spun colors. And in your bedroom, you can do a smartly matched ensemble because all home furnishings made with Chrome Spun are color linked to each other and color locked too. That means the colors are locked in against fading from sun and city fumes or washing and dry cleaning. See full color rooms done with House of Color fabrics in these leading home furnishing magazines. Look for the Chrome Spun House of Color tag and take the guesswork out of your home decorating.
And now Kodak invites you to enjoy The Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet.
I still say, why won't it work?
It won't work because it won't work.
Oh, that's a great reason.
Rick, do you mind?
Look, Wally, if you want to take a sunbath, why don't you go up on the roof of the gymnasium?
Look, let's get back to my problem. I still say this is the most sensible approach. This girl's an exchange student from Spain, and I'm an American trying to learn how to speak Spanish.
You're blocking the sun again, Rick. Look, if I don't get a tan, I'm going to flunk botany.
What's a tan got to do with it?
Oh, we were supposed to go on this field trip Sunday, and if I show up with this pale face, the professor will know I didn't make it.
Wait till he sees your exam paper.
Hey, Rick, getting back to your situation, this whole idea just isn't practical.
Well, no matter what you guys say, I'm still going to try it.
Well, good luck.
Are you coming, Wally?
No, I've been thinking over what you said about my examination paper. As long as I'm going to flunk botany, I might as well be the healthiest looking failure in the class.
There she is, Rick.
Hey, cut it out, will you?
What's the matter? Are you shy?
No, of course not. I've got to figure this out.
You've got it figured out. You're a poor American boy, and she's a Spanish girl.
Here, I'll make it easy for you.
Maria?
Hey, Zeke.
Oh, hello there.
Hi. You know Rick Nelson?
I've never met him, but I have seen him on the campus.
Well, Maria, this is Rick. Rick, this is Maria.
Hi.
Hello.
Hasta la vista, Rick.
Hey, Zeke.
Who is he?
Don't you know him?
No, I've never met him. I've seen him around.
Well, his name is Zeke. I'll have to introduce you to him next time.
Thank you. It has been nice meeting you.
Oh, just a second. You're an exchange student.
Yes, I'm from Madrid.
Oh, you speak English very well.
Thank you.
I don't speak Spanish very well.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah, in fact, I may not even pass the course.
Oh, that is a shame.
Oh, después de mí.
What?
Después de mí, after you.
Oh, you said after me.
I told you, I'm not doing very well in Spanish. So then I asked her if she mind helping me with my Spanish, and she said she'd be glad to. And I said, how about tonight? She said, fine, so I'll see you later.
Well, if you ask me, I think your friends are right. It's a pretty corny approach.
Well, it worked. How can you quarrel with success?
Well, but you're doing pretty well in Spanish.
Well, yeah, but I'd like to know more about it.
Sounds to me as if you'd like to learn more about Maria.
Well, Mom, the best way to get to know a language is to get to know the people that speak it. And Maria's one of the people, and she speaks it.
Well, you didn't have to go to all this trouble. You could have bought one of those language records.
Well, let's put it this way, Pop. Would you if you were me?
Hasta la vista.
Buenas noches, señor.
Buenas noches, señor. Señorita?
¿Tiene usted su libro?
Oh, yes, it's a lovely night, isn't it?
I ask if you had your book, libro.
Oh, libro. Yes, I have my libro right here. Gee, I sure am glad I came over. I really need these lessons.
Well, then, from now on, we will speak nothing but Spanish, see?
Oh, can't we wait till we get a little better acquainted? Why don't we take a drive around the campus?
No es posible.
I thought so. Back to the old libro.
Come on into the living room.
Oh, muchas gracias.
Buenas noches, Ricky.
Hey, what's this?
Well, after you asked me to help you with your Spanish, your friends came up and asked me the same thing. So I thought we might as well make a class of it.
Oh, thanks a lot, you guys.
Careful, Ricky. We're only supposed to speak Spanish here.
What I'm thinking, I couldn't say in any language.
Come on in now. Boy, I gotta hand it to you. I never thought that corny approach would work, but here we are.
¿Tiene ustedes un libro?
Sí, señorita. Tengo un libro.
What's the matter, Rick?
Oh, nothing.
He's an El Sorehead.
Shall we continue?
Oh, I beg your pardon. I didn't know anybody was here.
Oh, that's all right, Uncle Vicente. Come in. We're having a little Spanish lesson.
Oh, good.
Boys, this is my uncle, Señor Vicente Gomez.
Hello, boys. Don't let me interrupt.
Excuse me, Vicente Gomez. There's a famous guitar player named Vicente Gomez.
Yes, that is my uncle.
Well, how about that? You guys probably don't realize it, but Señor Gomez is one of the most famous guitarists in the world.
Oh,
Thank you. Very kind.
I have just about all your records, Señor.
Oh, that's very nice. Thank you.
See, I hate to impose on you, but would you mind playing something for us?
Would you? You sure you want me to?
Oh, yeah.
I will get your guitar.
All right, dear. What kind of music you prefer? Flamenco classic?
Well, anything.
Why don't you play the song you were playing this morning? It is so beautiful.
La Semana Santa in Sevilla.
Sí.
Como no? Somehow I have never been able to resist a lady's request, especially if she is my favorite niece. Thank you very much.
Gee, why didn't you tell me you had such a famous man in your family?
Thank you. Has Maria told you about her famous brother?
Oh, no. Who's that?
There he is, right there. Isn't he handsome?
Oh, yeah.
Does he play the guitar, too?
Are you kidding, Wally? Can't you see he's a matador?
One of the finest matadors in all Spain.
And I can vouch for that, too.
Boy, what an evening this has been. We've been entertained by a world-famous guitarist, we've met the sister of a matador, and I've learned how to say my aunt has a green couch in Spanish.
Well, I am glad the evening has been so successful.
Yeah, there's just one more thing I'd like you to do sometime. Invite me over for an enchilada dinner.
An enchilada? ¿Qué son enchiladas?
Oh, that is a famous American dish.
That can be arranged, too.
Thank you.
Come on, Wally. Say buenas noches and let's go home.
Buenas noches and let's go home.
Okay, boys. Nice to meet you.
Well, thank you. Same to you.
Oh, gee, I hardly got a chance to talk to her with all those other guys there.
Well, that's what you get for telling what you're gonna do.
Yeah. Well, at least they didn't do any better than I did. Oh, by the way, she's got quite a family. Her uncle's a famous guitarist and her brother's a matador.
A bullfighter?
Yeah.
Was he there?
Oh, no, he's still in Spain. I guess he's pretty good. Marie seems very proud of him.
Rick, here's an idea. If you want to get in solid with her, you ought to take up bullfighting.
Hey, that is an idea.
No, wait a minute. I was just kidding.
No, I don't mean I have to fight any bulls necessarily, but if I could learn something about it, it might give me a head start with Maria.
Well, it's worth a try.
Maybe I'll take it up.
Take what up?
Well, bullfighting.
Bullfighting?
Hi, fellas.
Oh, hi, Pop.
Hi, Miss Nelson.
What do you got here?
Well, it's a karatea.
Well, yeah, but what is it?
Well, I don't know the exact translation, but it's a practice bull.
Yeah, you see, you wheel it around this way and pretend it's a bull and the other guy's a matador.
Oh, yeah. How'd you learn about this?
Well, I went down to the library and got a couple of books on bullfighting. Here, let me show you how it works. Can I borrow your sweater?
What do you need my sweater for?
Well, I don't have a cape.
Oh.
Here, you explain this to Mom. We're going out of the costume shop and try and rent a cape. See you later, Pop.
So long, Mom.
Rick.
What's that?
Oh, this is a hole in my sweater.
No, I mean, what's that?
Oh, this is a practice bull.
What's it for?
Well, it's to practice bullfighting without a bull.
You mean you practice with that so eventually you can fight a real bull?
Yeah, that's the general idea.
Who's the bullfighter?
Ricky.
No, he isn't.
Oh, he just got this thing to learn something about bullfighting because of Maria. He's not going to fight a real bull.
Remember when David wanted a scooter, and then he wanted a bicycle, and then he wanted to put a motor on the bicycle, and finally he ended up climbing hills on a motorcycle?
Well, yeah.
You better get rid of this thing.
I can't do that. The boys just finished building it.
And you can finish tearing it down.
Oh, well, you can't get hurt with this. You be the bull, and I'll be the matador. Here, you just charge me.
Toto! Request permission from El Presidente to kill the bull.
What's the big idea?
Let that be a lesson to you, Pancho. Never turn your back on a bull or an angry woman.
This is Susie, 8 years old this week. This is Susie's dad. His camera is 8 years old this week, too. Susie sure has changed a lot in 8 years, and so have cameras. Suppose Dad had a brand new Brownie Starmatic camera. He'd get the right exposure time after time automatically. This amazing camera measures the light with its electric eye light meter and automatically adjusts the lens. When you shoot in the shade, the lens opens to admit the correct amount of light. And in the sun, the lens closes down. You get the right exposure at all times automatically. Beautiful pictures in deep shade like this, or in bright sun like this. All automatically. So why not take your pictures the modern way? The Brownie Starmatic costs only $34.50 or as little as $3.50 down. Other Brownie cameras start at $5.95. They're as new as tomorrow, and mighty good reasons to insist on the name Kodak.
Hi, Zeke.
Hi, Rick.
Are you going to be over at Maria's house tonight?
No, I don't think so.
Well, don't tell me you've given up taking Spanish lessons.
Oh, no, he's got a new approach.
Well, what's that?
He's taking up bullfighting.
Bullfighting? Well, that's a real corny approach.
What's so corny about that?
Stand back. El Toro is about to charge.
Buenos dias, senores.
Oh, hi, Maria.
Oh, hi, Maria.
What's going on?
Oh, we're just helping Rick. He's going to be a bullfighter.
A bullfighter?
Being a bullfighter is a very serious matter.
Well, he's serious about it, all right. Have you bought a bull yet, Rick?
Look, why don't you guys get lost?
Okay, we can take a hint. Come on, Zeke. We'll see you tonight, Maria.
Bye. Is it really true that you're interested in bullfighting?
Well, yeah, kind of. See, when you showed me that picture of your brother, the idea kind of intrigued me. So I read a couple of articles about it, and I thought I'd like to try it. I even built my own practice bull.
Oh, good for you. I would like to come over and see you practice sometime. Maybe I could show you some things my brother taught me.
Oh, gee, that'd be great. When can you come over?
Oh, any time.
How about this afternoon?
Oh, wonderful.
Hey, you know, maybe that isn't such a corny approach after all.
Pop?
Oh, hi, Rick.
Can I have the cape?
Oh, yeah, it was kind of cold. I just threw it over me.
Maria's coming over, and she's going to give me a couple of pointers.
Oh. Well, don't get too serious about this now.
Well, I won't. I hardly know the girl.
No, I mean about bullfighting. Oh, and you better put your guitar away. I almost sat on it.
I suppose it's too late to ask you to change your mind. I'm afraid it is, Dad.
There must be some other way for you to impress this girl.
Well, I've tried just about everything, but those other guys keep cutting in on me.
Well, if this is the way you want it.
Thanks, Dad. I knew you'd understand.
The summer wind-up is almost over. You're next, Nelson.
Well, Nelson's ready. Good luck, son.
Thanks, Dad.
Protect yourself at all times.
Behind the fence, Pop.
Well, good luck, son.
Thanks.
Oh, thanks. Keep weaving and bobbing, son. Watch your footwork. Don't let the bull get too close. Son down there. The one with the cape. Congratulations.
Oh, thanks, Pop.
A wonderful job. Well, come on, let's go, son.
Oh, no, it's not over yet, Pop.
What if you... Well, you took about four bows. Look, quit while you're ahead. Come on.
No, I have to get permission to kill the bull.
Kill the bull? Oh, no, Rick. I refuse to allow you to kill the bull.
Well, it's not up to you, Pop. It's up to the official.
Well, I don't care. I'm your father. Now, look, he's a very nice bull, and he gave a wonderful performance. I refuse to allow you to kill him. Now, go out and tell that to the people, Rick.
Okay, Bob.
You got to be firm with kids nowadays.
Ladies and gentlemen, my father has asked me to spare the bull. And he's not a man who usually spares the bull. So as a favor to my dear old dad, may I ask your permission to spare the bull? Pop?
Oh. Well, I guess I must have been dreaming.
Yeah, I guess you were.
Oh.
Thanks a lot for coming over. Gee, I don't know too much about the cave work yet.
You cannot expect to learn it overnight. My brother studied for many years.
Oh. Well, I'll go get the practice bowl and show you what I can do.
That will be fine.
Olé!
Olé!
And Heinrich, I'd like to make a few passes.
Oh, yes.
Permission to kill the bull. Bull,
bull. Uno más.
Come on, David. I want to take a shower, too.
What's the trouble there?
Well, David, he's been in the shower for 20 minutes.
Well, he'll be right out. I know he's got a date for tonight. Well,
I got to get down to the costume shop and return this cape, or they'll charge me for an extra day's rental on it.
Oh, did you give up the idea of being a bullfighter?
Yeah. What's the sense of being a bullfighter if those other guys are going to get in the act?
Yeah. Well, you just got to figure out something you can do that they can't.
Yeah.
Hey, she's going to be at the party tonight, isn't she?
Hey, yeah. Hey, thanks for the idea, Pa. Could I have your attention for a moment, please? I have a wonderful surprise for you. Señor Vicente Gomez has kindly consented to play something for us.
Thank you. Instead of playing a solo, I would like to ask Ricky to play a duet with me.
Good.
Honestly?
It will be a great pleasure.
Well, what do we play?
Well, I thought you told me we are going to play Sevillanas.
His idea.
How about that?
If I'd have known that, I would have brought along my accordion.
What for? You can't play it.
Long
fingernails. Play like that.
Oh, thanks. Would you like to hear another one later on?
Oh, yes. How about Tu Me Destrozas?
I don't think I know that one.
Well, do you know You Tear Me Up?
Oh, sure.
That's the English translation.
Oh, really? Well, you sure you want to hear it? It's rock and roll, you know.
Well, of course. If I wanted to hear Spanish music, I would have stayed in Spain.
Okay, I'll get my guitar.
Here shaking in a cold, cold sweat. You're making a fool out.
kiss. Never thought that love would ever be like this. Guess you know that I'm in love with you. I'd wish you'd tell me that you love me too. You're fooling around with my heart. Please don't be tearing apart.
It's very nice.
Oh, thank you. He's my son, you know.
Oh, I know. It's a very nice boy.
Oh, thank you.
You tear me up. I just wanna know if you love me too. Leave me now, I don't know what I'll do. So in love that I can hardly speak. My head is spinning and I'm feeling weak. So won't you consider my plea? Don't take advantage of me. When you put your arms around me, baby, you tear me up. I just wanna know if you love me too. Cause if you leave me now, I don't know what I'll do. So I'm in love that I can hardly speak. My head is spinning and I'm feeling weak.
My son. Oh, I told you that, didn't I?
Very nice.
Yeah. Next week, the adventures of Ozzie and Harriet will be brought to you by the Quaker Oats Company, makers of fine foods for the whole family. Now a word about one of the many fine Quaker products.
A hug, a kiss, and a good hot Quaker Oats breakfast. The best school day start you can give your youngster. For just as his soul is nourished by a hug and a kiss, so will his young body be nourished by a good hot breakfast of Quaker Oats. Yes, you'll keep him bright and alert for classwork, happy and healthy through the morning's active play with a nourishing hot breakfast of Quaker Oats with that wonderful oatmeal protein. Naturally, youngsters look forward to an occasional change for breakfast. So one morning, try maple syrup, blended right in while the oatmeal cooks. Another time, blend in honey or make it with chocolate. Yes, it's nice having an occasional change for breakfast, almost as nice as having a mother who starts the school day with a hug and a kiss and a good hot oatmeal breakfast made with Quaker Oats or Mother's Oats, the same high-protein oatmeal.
Brought to you on film by Eastman Kodak Company, who also present The Ed Sullivan Show on another network. And remember,
not even a Kodak camera takes pictures yesterday, so take some this weekend. Get Kodak film. Good night.